Good morning. Previously, we discussed the buoyant force which acts on submerged objects. Today, we are going to walk through a specific example, and then demonstrate it.
Flippin' physics.
Bo, please read the problem, and Billy, please translate.
Sure. This wood cylinder has a diameter of 50.7 millimeters and a height of 86.9 millimeters. If the density of this wood is 540 kilograms per cubic meter and the density of water is 1.00 times 10 to the third kilograms per cubic meter, what buoyant force acts on the wood cylinder when it is submerged in the water?
Okay, let's see. We know the diameter of the cylinder is 50.7 millimeters. However, let's convert that to meters because the densities are given in terms of meters. So multiply by 1 meter over 1,000 millimeters to get 0.0507 meters. And we probably want to use the radius in our equations, and radius equals half the diameter, or 0.0507 divided by 2, or 0.02535 meters. And the height is 86.9 millimeters, which we can convert to meters. It is 0.0869 meters. And we know the densities of the wood and water. The density of wood equals 540 kilograms per cubic meter, and the density of water equals 1.00 times 10 to the third kilograms per cubic meter. And we are solving for the buoyant force. So buoyant force equals question mark.
Well done. Bobby, please begin solving the problem.
Okay. We know buoyant force equals the weight of the fluid displaced by the object, or the force of gravity acting on the fluid displaced by the object. So that equals the mass of the fluid displaced by the object times the gravitational field strength. But we do not have the mass of anything. Instead, we have densities. So we need to use the density equation. Density equals mass over volume. We can rearrange that to get mass equals density times volume. So the buoyant force equals the density of the fluid displaced times the volume of the fluid displaced times the gravitational field. And I don't know what to do next.
I think we need to remember from last time that when an object is submerged in a fluid, the volume of the fluid displaced by the object is the same as the volume of the object itself.
Okay, yeah. The water is all around the wood cylinder, so the volume of the fluid the cylinder displaces equals the volume of the object.
I just want to reiterate that. If the cylinder were floating, the volume of the fluid displaced would be less than the volume of the object. However, the cylinder is submerged in the water, so those two volumes are equal.
Right. Thanks. And because it is a cylinder, the volume of a cylinder equals the area of the base times the height of the cylinder. Because the base of the cylinder is a circle, the volume is the area of a circle, pi times radius squared, times height. We have those numbers, so it's pi times 0.02535 squared times 0.0869, or 1.75439 times 10 to the negative 4 cubic meters.
Oh, so now we can determine the buoyant force. It equals the density of the fluid times the volume of the fluid times the gravitational field, or 540 times 1.75439 times 10 to the negative 4 times 9.81, or 0.92937, or 0.93 newtons with 2 sig figs.
Sorry, but no, this is not correct.
You forgot to say displaced by the object when you read the subscripts for the density and the volume in the buoyant force equation.
Buoyant force equals the density of the fluid displaced by the object times the volume of the fluid displaced by the object times the gravitational field.
Okay, I guess that is important. Let's go back to the knowns and specifically identify the density of the wood as the density of the object, and the density of the water as the density of the fluid displaced by the object. That should help, right, Mr. P?
I agree, that should help.
Good, okay. So that means the buoyant force equals 1,000 times 1.75439 times 10 to the negative 4 times 9.81, or 1.72105, or roughly 1.7 newtons.
Great. Thank you. Now, let's take a measurement to help determine the buoyant force acting on the wood cylinder when it is submerged in the water and see if the physics works. So, we place the wood cylinder in the water with this force sensor holding the wood cylinder submerged in the water. And you can see we get a measurement of, well, it looks like it is somewhere between 0.80 and 0.81 newtons.
The physics works?
What?
The physics does not work. The physics does not work.
I do not think that is correct, Bo. I bet the physics works, but we just do not understand how it works yet.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Mr. P said we are going to take a measurement to help determine the buoyant force acting on the wood cylinder when it is submerged in water. So we did not measure the buoyant force, right, Mr. P?
That is correct, Billy.
But then what did we measure?
We measured the downward applied force acting on the wood cylinder to hold the cylinder submerged in the water.
Yeah, we need to draw a free body diagram and sum the forces to solve for that force applied and see if it matches the observed value of roughly 0.80 or 0.81 newtons.
Oh boy. The buoyant force is up, the force of gravity is down, and the force applied by the force sensor is also down. That means the net force in the y direction equals buoyant force minus force applied minus force of gravity, and the net force also equals mass times acceleration in the y direction. Actually, let's specifically identify that as the mass of the object so we do not get confused. The acceleration of the object in the y direction is zero, so that whole equation equals zero. We already calculated a number for that buoyant force. It's 1.72105 newtons.
And I accidentally calculated the number for the force of gravity when I used the density of the object instead of the density of the fluid displaced by the object. The force of gravity acting on the object equals 0.92937 newtons.
Great! Now we just rearrange the equation to get force applied equals buoyant force minus force of gravity, and we get 1.72105 minus 0.92937 or 0.79168 or 0.79 newtons. And that is pretty darn close to 0.80 or 0.81, the force applied we measured using the force sensor.
The physics works! The physics works, the physics works. The physics works, the physics works.
That feels good.
It sure does.
It's been a while. It is good to be back. Okay, I do want to highlight two common mistakes students make when working with the buoyant force equation. The first is to remember that the density in the buoyant force equation is the density of the fluid displaced by the object, not the density of the object itself. Thank you, Bobby, for helping us to remember that.
You are welcome.
The second is to remember that the volume in the buoyant force equation is the volume of the fluid displaced by the object. Only when the object is submerged in a fluid is this the same as the volume of the object. When an object is partially submerged in a fluid, the volume of the fluid displaced by the object is less than the volume of the object.
Okay, when an object is floating on a fluid, the volume of the fluid displaced by the object is less than the volume of the object. Got it.
Yes, Billy. Thank you. And thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.